on again. I've just about put this second line in, and the other rod's going a bit mental. So I'm going to bring this. I'm just literally about to put that in the water, and I'm going to bring it in. I'm going to bring this one in, and I'm going to see what's on here. Bouncing about a bit, it was. Going a bit haywire, to say the least. Just to stick him in there, keep him nice and safe. Don't want no bloody punctures, you mean bloody dinghy. So I stick him there. Right. Get this place in. Don't want him getting in the way when I do catch something, if I do catch something. Right, tighten up on here. See what's going on, because he's starting to take lines. I think he's off. Oh, bloody hell, that's me just wishful thinking. There, bait's still on there. Well, he had it going anyway. I'm going to put it back in there and... Yeah, it was something. Something's on a little go. Bloody hell, that scared me. I thought my rod was in the water. Right. There's still a lot of UV. Right, he's on the bottom now. Right, I'll stick it back in. Put it back in there. Yeah. Right, we'll just chuck this second one in, alright? And then we'll see how it goes from there. I'm quite happy because I have caught something which is big enough to eat. Which is, you know, the whole point really. I think course fishing, you do want to catch something to eat. That's quite useful. Let's get some eel in the water. It's been a bit quiet for a while now, but I've been setting up on that because I've lost this rig. Yeah, it would be good to get another fish, I'll tell you what. It's quite good actually. It's worth the effort of lugging it all down here. This, because you know, if you do caught on the shore, you sit on the beach and that, you bring your rods down, sit up, do your cast, you've got dogs in the way, kids in the way, come here and do this. You might have to lug a load of shit down the beach, but I mean, when you do actually get out and